In this video, we will discuss how to select a material using CES Edupack. So in this case, we specifically want to look at the type of problem where we have a material index and we plot that on an XY plot of our two properties. So the case study we're going to be looking at for this example is from the textbook. It's section 5.2, and it goes through materials for rowing oars. And so if you remember, I've given you just a little picture of the schematic here. So we have the rowing oar we're assuming is a long beam, and it's being loaded by a force, by a weight. And it has some sort of deflection. So we can look this type of problem up in the back of the book. It's gonna be a beam in bending. And so in this case, we find that our material index is the elastic modulus to the 1/2 divided by the density. And we also know that we want to maximize the material index. So what we're going to look at is then how to select this using CES Edupack. So to select this using CES Edupack, we open up the software. I have already selected the level 1 database just for simplicity, but you could select one of the other databases. And we select the material universe level 1. And so over here on the left, we get the selection project window. If you don't see that, you can just come up here. You know, we can go, we have browse, search, we want select. We have level 1, and we want to select from, again, the material universe. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a two-dimensional XY plot of our materials. So to do that, we go over here to now selection stages, and we select graph. So now we are going to define the parameters that we want for our axes. So for the y-axis, we want this to be the elastic modulus. So I clicked category. It's going to be under mechanical properties, or you could look under all. So mechanical properties, and then our attribute is going to be the Young's modulus. Remember, Young's modulus is another name for the elastic modulus. These are the same parameter. The x-axis we're going to set is going to be our density. So our category, we could leave them all here if you want. Our attribute is going to be density. So when we've selected our x and our y axes, so now we can go down and we can select OK. And this creates an XY plot of these two parameters. So you can see all these materials, we have 69 materials here, and all of these materials are plotted. Now what we want to do is we want to draw in the line for our material index. So to draw in that line, we come up to these little icons up here. We choose the one that's the gradient line selection. We select that one. And here I'm going to enter the slope of my line. Remember, I take that elastic modulus, or I take that material index, you know, e to the 1/2 divided by rho. I take the log of both sides, I rearrange it, and we find that our slope should be 2. So we enter our slope, and we click OK. And now I can click anywhere on the plot, and it draws in a line with a slope of 2. If we come down here at the bottom, you can see where I clicked, the value of x and the value of y. My slope, again, is 2. And we also can see here what the value of our material index is. So here we see that that line, any point on that line, has a value of m equals 0.0165. And so actually, if I click on the line again, and I move... click on the line again, and I move it down, we see that those values of m get smaller and smaller. So now I'm down to 0.001. If I move my line up, m gets bigger and bigger and bigger. You know, so here we're already up to 0.02. And so if we remember from our problem, we specified that we want to maximize our material index. So we want to draw our line to be the largest value of m that still lets, you know, maybe 5 or 10 materials pass. And so we draw this line and we will put it here. And so what the software does is it's selected to shade everything below the line in gray. So those are the materials that don't pass, that don't fit our criteria. And it shades in, it colors in the materials above the line that are the materials that pass our criteria. So in this case, it guessed correctly and it shaded the right side, we want to maximize our material index, so we want the ones above the line to be shaded. But if we were going the other direction, what we could do, and we needed to minimize our material index and have these parameters, these materials down here, be shaded instead. Well, so what we can do is we can come over here to our stage where we said stage one, Young's modulus. We right click on that and I edit my stage. So this gives me the opportunity to change my X, my Y axis. You can also see, you know, if we want to hide some of the materials that didn't pass, we can do that. But we also up here, if we click on the top right, we can click on selection. And this is where you can see I select things that are above the line, but if we needed it to be in the reverse, we could also select below the line. So like I said, we'll leave it as above the line, but that's where you can change it if you need to. And so we've shaded in all of these materials. And so what we can do, you can see we have about 13 materials. If you want to get rid of a few more, we can go a little higher. We're down to 10, go a little higher. We're down to 7. And so now what we can do is we can label these materials. So if we click on the material bubbles, so I'm just going to left click here, you can see this is rigid polymer foam. Up here, this is going to be bamboo and wood along, oops, don't want to change the line, whoops. Okay, so wood along the grain. We also see that we get things like carbon fiber. We'll move this down. And I won't click each of these yellow bubbles, but we could label them. And we'll see that this one's silicon carbide. So all these yellow bubbles, those are going to be our ceramics. And so from this, if we were only going by material index, this is where we could take our line and draw, move it until there was only one material left. So we're down to 3, bamboo, carbon fiber, and silicon carbide. You know, we could find that, okay, carbon fiber, the edge of the carbon fiber bubble is the best. But the other thing is, remember, we need to keep it's best to keep a few materials in here. So we'll keep in, you know, these 6 materials, because then what we do, if we look farther into this and we go through the rest of the case study, is when we do our documentation, we see we research each of these materials and we see that some of these materials are poor choices. So silicon carbide is prone to fracture due to fracture toughness. And so we end up eliminating silicon carbide and we end up finding that carbon fiber reinforced plastic, CFRP, is in fact our optimal material. So this is how we can draw in, make our XY plot, our two-dimensional plot, and how we can draw in our material index line and select the materials using our material index line.